If you are planning on exchanging your Tet Blackstar weapon into a Godr weapon, my advice is to think twice before making this decision. For me, in my opinion, Godr weapons are terrible and is a waste of failstacks. The failstacks is far more important to me than the +2 AP increase that you get from the Godr weapons, even if you are trying to hit an AP bracket, because in the long run, you are spending more failstacks, cron stones, memory fragments, silver, and materials used in crafting the Scorching Sun gemstones. Try to do Godr doesn't need cron stones and it requires a failstack of at least 100. Do to try need 620 cron stones and a failstack of at least 150. Try to tet need 980 cron stones and a failstack of at least 170. Tet to pen need 1820 cron stones and a failstack of at least 200. As I've said, Godr weapons need a lot of failstacks and you could use those failstacks on other things like accessories. Now, when you look at the chart, it looks like you are saving cron stones, but not really, because the chances of succeeding is still pretty low and you end up using more cron stones. Now that we have the enhancing PT system or the Agris Essence system, if you look at it, it will show you that you actually have to fail more, especially in the Tet to Pen. You need to fail 50 times in order to get a guaranteed Pen Godr weapon, while you only need to fail 40 times for the Blackstar weapon. Now, I know this doesn't sound great because those numbers are pretty high, but if you look at the Blackstar weapon, it is much more closer and doable than the Godr weapons. You need to be lucky 4 times for the Godr weapons, while you only need to be lucky once for the Blackstar weapon. Also, if you add up all the Agris Essence for the Godr weapons from Duo to Pen, you need to fail 165 times for the guaranteed success if you are incredibly unlucky, while you only need to fail 40 times for the Blackstar weapon. If you are trying to pen a Godr weapon, the success chance is actually lower compared to a Blackstar weapon no matter what failstack you use, making it harder. Also, if you're trying to raw tap a Godr weapon, I don't think that's doable, unlike raw tapping a Tet Blackstar weapon, which is so doable and many has succeeded. I do believe, and by the way, this is just my opinion and observation, is that Pearl Abyss messed up the Godr weapons, and what I mean by that is that the Godr weapons are not meant to be a PT system for the Pen Blackstar weapons. I think that the Godr weapons are supposed to be like the Fallen God armors. These weapons are meant to give us the upgrade or the next level for the Blackstar weapons, just like the Blackstar armors into Fallen God armor. But for some reason, Pearl Abyss changed it, but that's just my speculation. I think Pearl Abyss held back because if you think about it, if they release the Godr weapons as an equivalent to a Fallen God armor, it's going to mess up all the grind spots in the game. It is much easier to grind if you have more AP than DP, because if you have more AP, then you can kill all the mobs way faster and you are most likely not to take damage, especially when it comes to ranged classes. Now, if you're in a situation where you really need that small AP and your only option is to get a Godr weapon, then go for it. But I still don't think that is a good idea. Godr weapons look so good on paper, but in the long run, it will be a very expensive route. And I know what you are thinking. You are going to sell the Godr weapon once you are done with it, but you still lose in that situation because for some reason, Godr weapons are cheaper compared to a Blackstar weapon. The only good thing I can think about the Godr weapons is that it looks cool, and that's about it. You can exchange your Pen Blackstar into a Godr weapon anytime, and you can also revert it back anytime. What do you guys think of the Godr weapons? Is it worth it? Write it in the comments below. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.